together.
Last week signified the end of opportunities for those who are on the fence about this schism. The time has come for you to pick a side. No longer will we turn the other cheek. And to anyone not sitting in the shade under the schism's tree, you've been warned. But to those enlightened few who choose to walk alongside us, brave enough to break the status quo, bold enough to sit with us under the schism's tree, you have nothing to fear. We will never abandon you. In fact, we will hold you tighter in our arms. The road to peace and inclusivity is a bumpy one, but our mission is to make the world a better place, and we accept that mission.
You all have brought this on yourself. Change can be scary, but we have given you ample time to accept the change. Now, whether you accept us or not, you will see the world through our eyes. Cameron Grimes, you have had multiple chances, and I have been more than patient. I have tried reasoning, I have tried compassion, but it seems that this world only responds to a firm hand. Cameron Grimes, you have made a life-altering decision, and to you and anyone else that refuses to listen, the wrath of the schism is imminent.
Buying any of that?
Whoa, and an offhand blade quickly making their way to the ring, and look, they're not going to sit under the schism's tree. They didn't even want to vote for Gacy last week, if you remember.
Yeah, absolute lunatic approach here.
Boom!
Enofe and Blade do not anger the schism in this way.
Gacy in disbelief. Enofe right now getting right into the face of Gacy. And well, it looks like we're going to have a match between these two teams.
Dyad were all over the place, but things have turned around in a hurry with Rick Fowler, as good as he is, taking control.
Right now, Schism, of course, certainly trying to spread their message, consider themselves stronger than ever.
Yeah, of course they do. They've been growing in confidence with every passing day, thanks to the soothing, calming words of Joe Gacy. With that man at the helm, there's nothing that the Dyad cannot achieve.
Fowler right now he's getting taken out first by Blade, and now Enofe charging right in into the cover. This would be a big victory. Hook of the leg, not enough. And this is a team that Enofe and Blade really looking to build some momentum.
Yeah, I'll say this about Enofe and Blade. I have liked them for a long time. They're upbeat, they're confident, they've got big personalities, and of course, fantastic athletes. Really just goes to show the depth of hungry,
oh, come on,
young. Even a five count, what are you complaining about? The depth of hungry young talent here in NXT, that even the likes of Enofe and Blade are not guaranteed a shot at anything right now, as good as they are. I will say, though, win tonight.
Read another cover kick out.
And Enofe and Blade will change that perception in a hurry.
All right, so is Schism whom you want to be spreading the message of NXT?
Yes.
They're the ones you want out there on the forefront?
I've done a 180 when it comes to Joe Gacy.
You've been reading the pamphlets, no, haven't you?
Listen, right now, why not Joe Gacy? Look what Joe Gacy has done for the Dyad. Saved their careers. Took them out of a tailspin and gave them a new lease on the floor.
Well, they're on a downfall right now. Blade wiping out both Fowler and Reed. Enofe adding to it. And now, looking to fly. Enofe and Blade rolling. Can they knock off the Dyad tonight on NXT? Dyad. Well, no no doubt who the NXT Universe behind and how big of a victory. Oh, tag was made. Blade does not realize Fowler now legal. And oh, a handful of that sweater. Blade right now is just getting taken out by Fowler and Reed.
By a fantastic tag team rejuvenated by Joe Gacy. Back to their best.
Why don't you get up and hug him? Go give him a hug.
I've got a job to do at the desk.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Embracing Joe Gacy, Fowler and Reed, and now just as quickly, Fowler turning right back around and looking to continue to just punish Blade in this match. Okay, well, what was the reason then for Joe Gacy to team up with Cameron Grimes? Explain that one to me.
Because he wanted to help Cameron Grimes.
Oh, you really think he wanted to help him?
No, let me answer the question. It was a two-on-one matchup thrown to the wolves. Only one man was coming out to save Cameron Grimes. That was Joe Gacy. They wanted to give Grimes one last chance. Joe Gacy is a good man. But Grimes, of course, too prideful, had to bite the hand that fed him that night. What a massive mistake that turned out to be.
He didn't need any help. That's the point.
He was getting battered in there. He was
in control for most of it until Gacy came out.
He was getting an absolute whooping. And here's the problem. Nobody in this world wants to listen to calm, soothing words that are logical that come from the mouth of Joe Gacy. They will only listen to a firm hand.
Oh, well, Blade now trying to turn things around in this matchup. And now able to get around both members, make the tag, and in comes an offense. Certainly fired up, is unleashing right now in this moment. How big would this victory truly be for Enofe and Blade?
Yeah, I'm not somebody who needs convincing when it comes to Enofe and Blade. 100 miles an hour stuff from them from the beginning here. Some apparently still need to be convinced about the magnitude of the powers of this tag team. A win against the Dyad, I promised you, every doubt disappears.
Well, finally, one member of the Dyad taken out, so it's now back to one-on-one, and it's Enofe taking full advantage. Ooh, driving.
Fast as lightning.
Fowler into the mat. Could be signaling the end of the Dyad tonight.
Don't go too quickly tag. There, Vicky Joe.
I believe a tag was made. Referee signaling for it. Big knee. Blade is legal. And you talk about tag team tandem offense.
This might be it right here.
Certainly could be. Look at the leg. Fowler getting the right shoulder up. I just peeked up from the desk and looked at Joe Gacy. Seemed very nervous. Bam! As Blade and Enofe driving Fowler into the mat. And there you see Gacy almost beside himself, almost a breathing a sigh of relief.
Yeah, he believes. He believes all along, does Joe Gacy. He believes in his man and their ability.
Oh, Fowler,
to do
Fowler
the
from behind. Oh, shoulders down, shoulders down.
Almost stealing one.
Yeah, how would that message be felt? The tag was made. Cheap shot going to the throat. Reed now on the back of Fowler. And now punching a one-way ticket for Enofe tonight.
That's an exclamation point. I think it was already over.
Here are your winners, the Dyad.
Even you're impressed by that, Vic Joseph. The hater Vic Joseph, lost for words. That's how good the Dyad are under the stewardship of Joe Gacy.
A sinister, sickening smile of Joe Gacy along
it's
with
loving.
The Dyad.
It's
not
loving.
There's nothing loving about that smile. But let's go back to some of the action. Right here, you saw Reed interfere into the matchup. This opened the door. It really was the signaling to the beginning. Bam! Of the end.
This was really superb stuff. Dyad firing on all cylinders. I don't care who you are. You're going down to a move like that. Fowler and Reed fans better than they ever have been before.
Wrath of Schism has begun, and quite the impression being left by the Dyad. It was last week another superstar left his mark. Of course, I'm talking about Quincy Elliott. Let's go back a week ago. I know you were impressed, Barrett. You were getting ready. The walls were shaking.